I'm Chris Wilson. Like me, many of you probably have a guitar or two tucked away you like to noodle around on. Or like me, you have a basement full of synthesizer and studio gear. But for years now, I've been getting more and more excited by the powerful music software available for desktop computers and lately even mobile devices. Now, I can replicate vintage synthesizer and processing hardware and software, which lets me stop filling up my basement while draining my checking account. Well, I'm here to tell you that all that exciting software can now come to the web platform with an amazing open web platform API called the Web Audio API. The Web Audio API was designed for several purposes. First of all, it's a great API for building sound for gaming. When we build games, we need to be able to make pew 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 sounds right when our users hit the button. You need to hear that massive explosion right as the screen lights up, or whatever. Now, this was hard to do with the HTML5 audio element, which wasn't really designed for precise timing, multiple simultaneous sounds, or memory management. But the Web Audio API also lets you crack into the world of digital audio in a big way. You're in control of the audio path itself, with powerful but easy-to-use processing nodes to create effects like delay, filtering, reverb, and more. Now, the Web Audio API lets you create rich, multiply layered effects by giving you the primitives you need to do the job, like delay nodes, gain control, filtering, even complex primitives like convolution. The goal isn't to give you all the complex final effects you could ever want. It's to give you all the primitives you need to build more complex effects. When I first started playing around with the Web Audio API, I wanted to see just how far I could take the processing system. So for a past Google I/O, I wrote a vocoder application. Now, vocoding is a fairly complex process. It takes one sound source, like me talking to you now, and it chops it up by frequency bands. Next, it takes the volumes in those bands over time, and it applies them dynamically to the same frequency bands in another sound, usually a synthesizer sound.
Now your cube is bound with a robot. You can raise your brain. You can even change your budget or become a steam robot. Don't blame me, I'm so funky.
You can also use Web Audio to create other audio processing effects, like chorus effects,
or pitch shifting. I'm talking to you, Kent.
Or you can become Alvin, Simon, or Theodore. Should I give the rest of my talk like this? No, probably not.
To implement each of these effects, though, I didn't write JavaScript code that acts directly on the sound buffers. I wrote code that combines the processing nodes that Web Audio gives me, and it does all the work. Okay, so you can perform real powerful processing with Web Audio, but where does that sound source come from? Where do you get started? Well, as I just demonstrated, the sound can come from the user's audio inputs. Via WebRTC's Get User Media API, you can hook the audio inputs of your computer. Sometimes that's just the microphone on your headset, but you can also have a pro-quality audio interface with a killer AX plugged in. Web Audio can also hook any media element's audio output, so you can grab the audio output from video or audio elements. This can make it easy to do just some basic processing, like gain control or filtering, on an audio element that may be streaming from the server. But sound sources can also come from audio samples that you load, through XML HTTP request most likely, and you can use Web Audio to decode from MP3, WAV, or OGG format to a buffer. When you play those buffers back in Web Audio, you can also change their playback rate or detune them. This makes it easy to take a simple sample, like this one I recorded of me tapping a wine glass, and turn it into a playable musical voice. And finally, if you don't want to use recorded sound, you can use Web Audio's natively implemented oscillators. If you're an old synthesizer nut like me, you'll know that oscillators create a basic waveform, like a sine, square, sawtooth, or triangle wave. This makes it easy to produce basic audio blips, bleeps, and bloops. Of course, oscillators also make it completely possible to build much richer synthesizers without ever loading a sound file, like with this digitally replicated analog synthesizer I built. I tried to dig up a keytar to play this live, but I couldn't find one. Now, oscillators aren't just for building synthesizers, they're also the key to creating a lot of effects and complex sounds. Many effects, like the very common chorus effect, use oscillators in the background. Chorus is really just a delay with a constantly varying delay time. That variation is caused using an oscillator. this kind of control is possible because of Web Audio's powerful, flexible audio parameter and routing system. Most parameters can be controlled and scheduled at the rate of the audio. This makes for some amazing effects. For example, for those of you who remember the 80s, you can build FM synthesizers, similar to Yamaha's DX7, because you can modify one oscillator's frequency with another oscillator at an audible frequency, and that creates that classic FM synth bell-like sound. Working with the Web Audio system's routing and parameter schedule can be a little daunting at first, but think of it like a queue of notes that you need to keep full. It's sort of like when you sight read sheet music. You need to look ahead a bit of where you are to keep your playing fingers primed. The audio system is busy under the hood generating and processing the sound stream and keeping the sound output happy by pushing a continuous stream of audio bits at it. So really, the least you can do is give it a little heads up for what it will need to be playing soon. I wrote an article a while ago about Web Audio scheduling for HTML5 Rocks that can help you better understand this system, and it can help teach you to create rock-solid timing for musical applications, even with JavaScript's not always rock-solid event delivery timing. This makes it so you can easily build drum machine and sequencing applications that keep a rock-solid beat while still responding in near real-time to parameter changes. One more critical piece to building musical applications is control. In the music world, nothing beats having a real physical instrument to finally control your sound. So we've been building support for a standard called the Web MIDI API that lets music controllers, like this, or this, or even this, get plugged straight into the web platform so you can use them for direct control of your web applications. This lets me have direct, physical, immediate control over these great audio capabilities. Now, the Web Audio API is available on Chrome, Firefox, and Safari today, and Internet Explorer recently began development as well. But finally, I want to leave you with one mind-blowing revelation. All of these things I've been talking about, all the incredible power of the Web Audio API, all of this works on the mobile web as well, with modern mobile browsers. iOS Safari and Chrome for Android both implement the Web Audio API. In fact, Chrome for Android even has an experimental implementation of Web MIDI, so you can build amazing web music applications and take them with you wherever the web goes. So I hope I've inspired you with some of the things you can do with the Web Audio and Web MIDI APIs. Let's get out there and make the web rock.